All right, so it's been a while since I've made a video about trading, and well, today I finished $4 in profit. I know it's not a lot, but today it could have been a huge red day, given that I was YOLOing a lot into HOOD on FOMO, and then also this stock here, BYSI. I was trading this. I literally saw this pre-market. I watched it go all the way up, and I didn't trade it until right here. Let me pull up my trades here. I decided to go in three shares into the open. I thought it was going to squeeze up and at least retest VWAP, and I could have at least got maybe $3 a share. But it ended up dumping, and I had to manage my risk down here, so I let it dump down. It halted on this level here, and then it resumed and it ripped back up maybe about another $1.50. And then I sold, you know, to manage my risk. And then I bought this dip here and sold literally, I made like 20, 40 cents. So I, on that ticker, I lost about 15 bucks out of the gate, because I disobeyed my rule, and my rule is never to hold a position from pre-market into open, but I just thought this stock would be different and it would actually rip up because it was just downtrending so long on this trend line here, and I thought it was at least going to retest the VWAP, but didn't end up happening. But I cut my loser, you know, I mean, $15 on three shares on this thing is fucking pretty bad, but it is what it is. Then I started seeing HOOD pop up, squeezing straight up, and I completely missed the front side. I thought it was too risky just to start jumping in. But then on the back side, I bought this dip here. Then I bought, okay, I bought four here, and then I bought eight more, and then I sold them all for like a 15 cent gain. Down here I bought the dip, and then I bought the dip again. Somehow I bought 44 shares here, so I was in 50 shares in here at 62. I was freaking nervous as hell. I thought this could be the end right here, but I held my end, and I at least wanted to get back to break even. So I sold 20 about at break even, and then sold 30 for a little bit of a profit, and then I bought this dip here at 62 and sold into 98 cents, and then bought some more here on this dip, and then was able to, well, this I sold 10 here, that might have been from that order, but 15, yeah, so 15, 65, 14, and then sold 15 at 65.92 for like a nice, I ended 16.94 in profit. So that pretty much offset my stupid BYSI trade that I made. And then right here, I just literally just got chopped up. I was feeling the FOMO. I thought I was going to curl back up and then break through VWAP like it is right now and go like all the way past 70 and go higher. But didn't end up doing that, and I just kept getting chopped up for small losses and small wins on small size. So that is that. But this move is crazy, though, on the IPO volatility. I guess everybody started jumping on board here and squeezing it all the way up like $20, $25 a share. And then for some reason, BYSI didn't really want to push any higher. I thought it was really going to squeeze past 46 and go all the way past 50 just because of how like much a squeeze at the open. I thought we were going to get another move like that, but we didn't end up getting that. So it is what it is. I mean, this could have been a very bad day. I was holding 50 shares, like I said, with HOOD. This could have easily just like reversed again for another leg down all the way down to 58, and I could have been down easily $200 on the day. Could have been a very bad. I don't want to ever do that again. I was just feeling a lot of FOMO. I felt like everybody was making money on this move. And when it's dipped, I was like, on the first dip, I'm getting in. And I went in 50 shares, kept averaging down. those are the types of moves that give me the largest losses, is when I just keep averaging down, instead of what I should have been doing is waiting and waiting until I should have drew that out, this support line before, and then wait for it to kiss this line here, and then just pile in where I did right here, but actually wait and not start adding so early. Waited to this point here, adding in at 64, 63, and then wait for this bounce, and I could have made an easy $3-4 a share there. And then also on this double bottom here, on lower selling volume, after this candle made a new low on lower volume, it's actually a sign that it's going to bounce, and it's a bullish sign for a scalp. So I was adding here, I should have waited instead of adding on this candle. I should have waited for the bottom of this candle at 62s or low 63s and adding in and then on this candle taking off my profit. And I could have made a good $4 a share there. But, you know, hindsight is 20/20, and it is what it is. I mean, I always get very nervous trading these very supernova type volatile stocks, the parabolic squeezes. I get very nervous trading those. Pretty much to start like freezing up, and I start getting FOMO and emotional, and like, wow, I'm letting the perfect opportunity pass by me right now. That's what I'm thinking. I'm letting the perfect opportunity pass me by, and I'm not taking advantage of this. And like all these what ifs, and like it really fucks with my trading, and I start getting in too soon and cutting my winners too soon, and I just start trading emotional. So I knew that I got really lucky that I didn't take a huge loss on this. So, I mean, $4 a share, I'll take it. It's been a while since I made a video, so I'll update you guys on my stats. After that week of losing pretty much all of my profit, I made like $1,000 in 4 months, and then I gave back $800 of it, $850 off of it in 2 days of trading. And I convinced myself that I was going to quit trading. I was pretty much done trading, and I was like, fuck it, I'm going to go to the beach. So I went to the beach, and like I was already convinced myself that I was done trading, and I was never going to do this anymore, and I was going to move on to something different. But like even in my head, I was like, oh, cool, like I'm done with this. You know, I felt really relieved that I didn't have to do this anymore, and like it caused me so much pain. But the next day, I wake up, and I freaking walk right back to my trading station. I sit down and I start looking at the market again at 7 o'clock in the morning, and like I usually do. And I just, it's almost like I can't walk away. I even convinced myself to walk away, and I can't walk away. Like I can't quit trading. I feel like I feel just too gravitated towards this career that I cannot give up, and I've come so far, and I'm so close to being consistently profitable and going full time, that if I were to give up here, this would be idiotic. I know I have what it takes, and it's just gonna take time and making those failures and losses and learning from them. So came back and I started trading again. Very, 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 very micro size. 1 share, 2 shares, 3 shares a trade. And I did that for about a week or two. And I'll pull up my metrics here. I did that for about a week or two. Yeah, right down here. So I gave back a lot of profit from off this. So it's about, yeah, it's 850 bucks. And so I was just literally micro size, and I was just going sideways for a while. My confidence was shot. I really was emotional on every trade, cutting my losers too soon and cutting my winners too soon, barely like just kind of scalping, making pennies. And then eventually it started coming back together. I started figuring out my strategy again and where I was at before that I made all that money in the beginning of the year, and I started picking back up again, and eventually started scaling up my share size. And my smallest share size that I would start with was 5 shares, and then I would add another 5 shares, and then eventually I started with 10 shares and then add another 10 shares and added more shares as my resolutions starts to unfold in the trade. And now I am at maybe like 20 20 share, 25 shares starting position, and then adding doubling my position as I see resolution on my trades, and then taking them off into the breakout. Right now, I haven't been really holding through the breakouts just because this market has been not favorable to breakouts and holding them through with momentum. So I've just been taking it off on the breakouts. Been working very well. I've been making a decent amount of money per trade given my share size. So very happy with that. And now I'm just kind of like going back to where I was before and sizing back up. You can clearly see that my winners just keep getting bigger and bigger as I gain more confidence. Yesterday I had a $63 day after a $26 loss. I forget the loss that I had was yesterday. EVK maybe? Or HJLI. I had a huge loss on HJLI. Yeah, I thought I was going to squeeze through this VWAP here, so I was adding into this breakout. I was in 60 shares here, and then it flushed. I was able to sell 20 shares before the flush here at the top, and then the rest. I was actually going to hold the rest of the 40 through all the way up until a retest of the highs, but then I'm flushing. I ended up stopping out down here and taking a like $25 loss or something like that, $26 loss. So that was yesterday. I mean, I did the right thing. I cut my loss and managed my loser. So, but then the next day I came back swinging yesterday, and I was able to have a really good trade on APDN. I was in 200 shares at my highest. 220 shares on this rip. I was adding into this halt here, and then I took most of it off at the halt level, and then held the 50 more shares as it resumed, and I was able to take some off for more profit, and I was able to make a good $60 on that. So that was really good. So here I'll show you my cumulative profit and loss. So look at here in October, this is when I first started trading, going live at least. Before, I was paper trading for about 6 months. And then I started to get the hang of it and going up and up and up and up and up. And then I got cocky up here and I had one loss of like 50 or 80 bucks that I was like, fuck this. I cannot have a red day like this anymore. So then I started YOLOing my whole portfolio, if you guys remember. In one of my last videos, I was YOLOing my whole portfolio on with margin, 100K, into shorting the SPY because the market started dropping. And then it reversed on me. I kept taking paper cuts after paper cut after paper cut on like 200 shares of the SPY priced at like 400 bucks. And in 2 days, I just completely like... I just kind of gave up emotionally. I was like, I don't even want to hold on to this anymore. Just fuck it. Just take it. Take my money. That's what I felt emotionally. And then I had to catch myself, and like, I couldn't go any. Luckily it didn't go. I didn't go negative on my portfolio because that would have been really bad. Lucky I only lost 800 bucks and not more than that. And it's recoverable. And then I started making my trek back. So now I'm close to my highs again. So maybe about 200 bucks off my highs. And slow and steady, I'll eventually get there and break through. And I'm just going to continue what I've been doing and not get cocky. And once I have a good green day, maybe start to not like kind of manage my emotions and my confidence, make sure I'm not... don't get too greedy on those moves and adding too heavy into the breakouts if we're seeing momentum, because it only takes one really bad false breakout and I give back like a couple days or a couple weeks worth of profit. So I just have to manage my risk and can't lose my risk management through like my emotions. So my profit factor right now is a 1.3, so that's pretty good. I mean, I'm winning more than I'm losing, but my average loser is a little bit bigger than my average winning trade. That's because it kept having these big freaking, it had this big drawdown. That's probably why. But I just want to keep this number over one, and then I'm going in the right direction. So that is my review. Since my last video, which I ended on a very bad note, and I kind of just started to feel like I should start making some videos just because it's been a while, and I definitely want to keep documenting my trading journey because I know other people need, at least for me, like I need other people to, you know, show me how that it can be done, you know, and I like when other people document their journey and how they deal with their emotions and their thought processes as they're learning how to trade. And so that's why I kind of want to document my own trading journey so you guys can have somebody to relate to and also realize that you are not alone, and everybody who trades has the same emotions that you do and the same levels of fear and greed and managing their emotions and YOLO moments in the market, and that all of that can be managed. All of that can be managed if you are very mindful of yourself and kind of get to know yourself and how you react in different markets. So I just wanted to do that review since the last video, and you'll probably see a lot more review videos from here on out. Maybe not one every day, but probably on a weekly basis, at least when I'm not working. Right now I'm kind of trading in the morning, and then I work from lunch through dinner, and then I get home and I read some books or do some meditation, and then I go to bed, and then I wake up and do it all again. That's my routine, so not really much time to make videos about trading unless it's my day off. So probably once a week I'll be doing videos. Hope to see you guys on the future videos, and I hope you guys get good value out of my content. I know I'm rambling here, but I hope you guys get good value out of my content, and I hope you guys return to my future videos. Peace.